Elijah.
Was.
Absent.
On.
October 15th, 2012.
For periods.
03.
Please send a note or call 385.
Yeah, fuck you guys, because really, finally I get the message. Not the 12 absences that he had for the entire month. I went in there and reamed somebody in the office, because you're supposed to get notified. Supposed to get notified. Well, they don't have my number in the thing. I don't know why. It's in the fucking form. I can see it sitting there while I'm talking to the lady. And I didn't show up till after third period because I wasn't going to have him go back to school. But he had to take testing, which we found 5 minutes into the meeting with a counselor. Like, you can't unenroll him and enroll him into anything else because he has testing that he has to complete. Oh, when is it? In 5 minutes? Great. Today and tomorrow. So dropped him off, didn't want to because I was scared he was going to take off. He ended up being there this evening, which is good. I'm grateful, thankful for that. Got a call from Elsie at the school. He was in a panic, like freaked out. Mama, come and get me. There's a lockdown. I'm scared. Come and get me. Got there. Luckily, I was able to get onto campus. If you guys watched the video beforehand, luckily, they were just out serving a warrant, but those warrants, I guess, they've done in the past have ended up in a shootout with people getting shot and stuff, so they had to lock down the school as a precaution. Then my daughter came home to let me know that somebody, I don't know, nobody that she knows, but a 15-year-old girl committed suicide over the weekend. I don't know if this is a national thing, if this is a local thing. She didn't even have all the information, but something that happened that they were discussing in class over cyberbullying. So got home, just like I said, within an hour, because I have a cyst on my ovary. Like, I have them pretty regularly enough to know that that's what that is. Might not be sure about this whole gallbladder issue, and even though I'm pretty sure that's what it is, being that I have all the symptoms, but the ovary, yeah, pretty well aware of that. I've been dealing with that for years, and just in a lot of pain, decided to get into my comfy clothes, roll myself into a little potato bug, dying cockroach position. Then I got a call from my tax guy saying, you need to come down and do the paperwork now because this is the last day. You have 40 minutes. At which time you're supposed to pay for all of that. Well, guess what? Guess who didn't make it to the bank, didn't have the money, could pay all the rest of the bills earlier today, all happy, paid the bills. So guess who didn't have the money for the tax guy? This girl. So what do? I go and take my change things. I'm like, oh, I got money in there. I'll go do that. So I drive all the way back across town, add a change, go back across town. The Coinstar is not working at the bank. Yeah. And I call him back up and tell him basically I can't do it. Can't do it. This is really shitty. I haven't been working for the last couple of weeks because I've been all mental. And luckily, the guy that's our tax guy is my friend's, well, acquaintance's grandfather. And my grandmother and grandfather run the business, and they told us, well, we love you guys, and we understand, and pay for it when your taxes come back. We already filed for you. Don't even worry about it. So thank God. Thank God. Thank God that's done. I'm happy, because that is great. That will be done here soon. Everything will be all good. But I'm exhausted. I'm in pain. I'm ready to chillax. I just threw leftovers in the microwave for the children. The husband won't be home for 2 hours. And despite the fact that it was a manic, crazy Monday, I still have a dozen things that I'm thankful for as I'm sitting here bitching. I am thankful, thankful, thankful that my son was okay. Both of them, that all of them are okay today. They're safe. That's not going to be my attitude of gratitude, though. I have other things to be grateful for. I feel like I can pick and choose. When only, like, 11 weeks ago, I couldn't find a single fucking thing, people. Not a single fucking thing. Now I have a list of things like, God, what am I going to be grateful for today? So, yeah, just I am overwhelmed. I do feel like I'm going from place to place and doing all these things, and it's like I was talking to Michelle on here earlier, and she's like, could you have any one more thing? Like, okay, gallbladder, kid taking off and not doing what he's supposed to be doing. I'm a cyst on your ovary, and you know, this and this and all these other private things that I haven't even shared on here. Like, can I have any more stuff? Can we just load it all up? I guess fucking load it all up so I can deal with it and get it all over one shot. Just fucking bring it. Like, bring it. Because the 19th is Friday. Like, really? It's just like the universe is just pile this shit on. Just keep piling that shit on there and let's just see how much we can give her and let's see how she comes out. And I know I'll be fine. Oh, I know I'll be fine. Oh my God. It's not my back. It's my chest. And if it's not my chest and my back, it's my ovary. I wish they would have taken those fucking things out. I know some of you are going to be like, no, you don't. You really don't want that because then you have to take hormones and all this other stuff and it'll make you all erratic and... Come on. Can I get any more erratic? Could it get any... I'm not going to say, could it get any worse? Here's another thing, people. Don't ever, ever, ever pray for patience. Ever, ever, ever pray for patience. I can't even speak. Because you'll get that shit. Like, they'll throw at you just so that you can see, like, yeah, you want to learn how to, you know, have patience? Let me just throw all kinds of stuff at you, and then you'll learn patience. I didn't get to go and listen to any of the Love and Logic or any of the other stuff. I didn't get to call my doctor. The last fucking thing I needed to do was to call my doctor, and I didn't get a chance to call my doctor. And it wouldn't have mattered anyways, because I couldn't have got out there today. If I would have gone out there today, I would have missed picking up Elsie. And I wouldn't have, all this other stuff, like nothing. I just need a good book. I need a good book. I need some chillax. I need to eat, because really, a little Jell-O cup and the salad is not enough. And I need a shit ton of more water. Is what I need right now. And my husband. I would really like it if my husband were home. I can't wait to move the fuck out of here, you guys. I really can't. I cannot wait to move the fuck out of here. I just wish we could go now. I just wish. It's like, it's, what is it? It's like money or time. Like, I just don't have the money to move. Like, if I had the money to move, like, I would pack up my shit and say, fuck the whole rest of the year, school year for the kids or anything else, and we just get out of here. We would just go. That would be it. I'm done here. I'm pretty much over it. And this was such a cool place to live, like, 6 years ago. It was okay. I have this all wonky, I know. I don't even know. I'm pretty much done for Monday. Like, I'm throwing up the white towel on Monday. I don't even know what else to say. I'm gonna go chillax, because that's all I can think to do right now for the pain is just chillax. I'm not gonna lie, though, like, an hour ago, I'm glad I was that close to just taking a pill. Like, really that close to just taking a Vicodin or something and just, like, numb out my pain in my stomach. Just numb it out. But I'm gonna go chillax and drink a lot more water and wait for this thing to go away. Burst or whatever the fuck it is they do. And I may or may not check in later, being that just depends on pain level and all that stuff. I don't know. We'll see. There's nothing else to fucking